Welcome to another Max2Play tutorial. Today we will explore the extension Raspberry settings and the possibilities of Max2Play using sound cards. A selection of sound cards, including the M+ and the DAC+ by HiFiBerry, are perfectly optimized for out-of-the-box use in our extension Raspberry settings. In order to take advantage of this great combination of the Raspberry Pi, a powerful sound card, and our Max2Play image, we need to take a few steps to set the system up. First of all, we need to install the Raspberry Settings extension. We can do that in our Settings Reboot menu under the Plugin Configuration. Now, since Raspberry Settings is not a pre-installed extension, we have to find it in our website. And that's not really hard. We just have to go to Features, Extensions, and here we can find a list of all our extensions. Raspberry Pi Settings, as you can see here, is the first one. So all we have to do is click on this button, copy the text that's shown here, go back to our web interface, and paste it into the Enter URL. And now we click Install New Plugin, and just a few seconds, can see here, successfully installed. Now it shows up in our available plugins, and we can put it into the active plugins, click Save, and it will show up in our menu right here. Now if we go to this setting, we can see here already that he's already detected our Raspberry Pi 2. And what he doesn't know is that we also have a DAC+ by HiFiBerry connected. And in order to set this up properly, we have to select the sound card here, the HiFiBerry DAC+ for Raspberry Pi 2. Now if we click on Save, you can see here that everything is set up and the parameters are changed to perfectly work for the HiFiBerry DAC+. And in order to have these changes enacted, we have to go to the settings menu and make a reboot. Now it takes a few seconds for the system to boot back up, and when it's done that, we have to make some more adjustments to our audio players because we want Squeeze Lite, our preferred audio player for the Squeezebox server environment, to work properly. So we have to go to audio player and set up the settings there as well. Now we go to edit advanced options. In here we can see the sound card option, and here we have our default setting for the HiFiBerry DAC+. We select that and click Save. And now we should have our Squeeze Lite player perfectly set up for the HiFiBerry DAC optimum value. Now another thing we have to be careful about is the SharePort player, because we can't have any other player interfering with Squeeze Lite when we use the DAC+, because the DAC+ and some other audio cards have a problem with multiple players running. So we need to stop the SharePort, and we also have to make sure that the auto start is not enabled, because otherwise the AirPlay SharePort will just start back up again. Save that as well. And now we have everything set up for our DAC+ to play through Squeezebox. And in order to make sure that we have AirPlay working as well, since we can't use SharePort, we have a little workaround on our Squeezebox server menu. If you take a look here, down there you can see the option Install Special Plugins for Squeezebox Server. And already pre-decided, you can see here, is Install ShareTunes Plugin. And you just click Install Chosen Plugin. And this will take a few moments, but Once this plugin is installed, the Squeezebox server is able to work with AirPlay, and all the squeeze players, as you can see here, can be used as AirPlay devices. Thanks for watching. This has been another video of Max2Play, and if you are interested in a good sound card for Max2Play, the Raspberry Pi solutions from HiFiBerry, DAC Plus and the Amp Plus are available in our Max2Play store.